A global toy company is selling its toys across different markets. Is it multiple SKUs, say bus, trains, cars? And we have to analyze its sales performance across different geographies. In the first two sessions, we learned how to do data transformation and how to understand data so that we can do data analysis. Today, we will focus on how to do data analysis and most importantly, how to develop dashboard for visual storytelling. Please watch the video till the end for better understanding. But if you are particularly interested in any particular section, you can skip to that section as well. If you are new to the series, my suggestion is to look at my other two videos first, and the links are given above. Let's begin. If you're watching this far, that means you're serious about learning fundamentals of data analysis. So, to get regular update on tricks and tips of data analytics using Excel, please subscribe to Data Bicep. Do not forget to like this video to send your regards to the whole of analyst community. Suppose we have to answer a very broad question. That's, how are my products selling? And if you have to answer this question, it has three questions into it. The first is that, what is the sales trend of different product lines? The second question we need to answer, what is the percentage share of wallet for each of the product line? The third in, which are the best selling markets for each of the product lines? And if you have to answer these three questions, let's do one thing. Let's go back to our original data set and insert a pivot table. So click insert, click pivot table. Okay, and we will create the pivot table in a new sheet. Just click OK. Now, in order to answer these questions, what we need to understand our product lines. So find the product lines and drag it to the rows. Since we have to understand the trend, click the year, put it into the column. And at the end of the day, we are trying to understand our sales, right? So drag the sales here. Just make sure that it's sum. Let's change the number format to a number and click OK. And this gives the sales trend for each of the product lines. And we clearly see the classic car is selling the most. Now, in order to answer the next question, that is, how much percentage share of wallet each of the product line is contributing to the whole of sales. So let's copy this, paste into a different location, right click it, and say show value as percentage of column total. So what it does, instead of showing absolute values like earlier table, now it's showing the percentage to the entire column. That means in 2003, almost 42% of my sales came from only classic cars. And it shows a very interesting trend. That means there is another SQ plane, which is picking very fast and which is slowly contributing to more and more of the share of wallet. Now let's try to answer the third question. What are our key markets? Now copy this table again, paste it here, and we'll change it. We'll change it to the different market segments. So take this product line out. Instead of there, let's go to country. Now clearly you see, this is how my country's market share is. If you want the absolute value, again change it, show value as, no calculation, and it will start showing the absolute value of sales per market. And there is no end of doing analysis. It's always tied to the questions asked. Since we were asked these three questions, we created these three pivot tables. If the questions were different, we would have analyzed in different ways. Now let's go to the next step to see that how we can visualize our finding in a dynamic dashboard setting. Reporting or visualization is the most important aspect of your analysis because finally your analysis is only as good as you present it. Most of the time it's purely art, and that comes from your understanding of the subject matter. I will dedicate one complete session on how I build this dashboard, but today let's see how a sample sales analysis dashboard may look like. On the left hand side, I have three slices to show the sales from different point of views. It has order date, it has territories, and it has product lines. With that, there are three major visuals to help you understand how the sales happen in different countries. It talks about different customers and sales trends of different product lines. And you know why we are providing this dynamic dashboard? Because if you provide this dynamic dashboard to a sales head, he can derive required information the way he want and when he want it. And big advantage of any dynamic dashboard is that for all small changes, the executive doesn't need to come to you for analysis or to make the changes. That saves a lot of communication time. Now let's look at the dashboard. If you want to see how is the performance of EMA region, you just have to click it and it refreshes this entire dashboard accordingly. It shows that what are the countries in the EMA region, and it says that Spain has the most of the customers. It talks about the customer names, what are the sales, what is the volume of sales, and what the sales trend has been for different product lines. Now, if I want to see what the trend for classical cars are, then you just have to click classic cars and you see this is the trend, and you will see that quarter on quarter the trend is changing. And if you want to compare that with motorcycle, just you have to click it again and you see two graphs, and respectively all the graphs and charts get refreshed. So this is the beauty of a dynamic dashboard. Now it's your playground. You can filter the data the way you want it, so play with it. If you have an idea of building a sales dashboard, please comment that below. How would you build that?
Please like, comment, and subscribe Data Bicep.